workout today. It's nice out. It's like almost like 60 degrees outside right now during the winter, which is odd. You know, that's the thing I don't get about Mother Nature. But I'm getting a workout in today. I'm sitting on the floor, online coaching fitness. And like I said, just hit the like, hit subscribe if you are new to this channel. And another thing is, you know, always stay safe, always do your research on training. And if you need, you don't have a whole lot of space, you know, you can go to your local park, train. You can go to your local gym and train. I'm sure they'll allow you to let weapons in, you know, as long as you just don't use it on anybody or anything like that. And other than that, you know, like I said, it's nice out. I'm going to be making a video. I'm going to do instructional on it. I ought to do instructional on it one day, but I'm not going to do instructional on it. Basically, I just do freestyle. I'm not really good at it. I just do drills. That's all I do. So I just learn just by watching other people do their stuff. That's just how I do it, and that's just how I learn. I never really got taught how to do the sword. It's just I just learned everything on my own. I did got taught a little bit of the sword when I was in Taekwondo. I was winning competitions like crazy. And when it comes to sword training and doing like sword katas and everything else, and I mean I brought home first place all the time with it, but I never really stuck with my kata that I was doing, so I can't really remember on what the kata was about. I remember bits and pieces of it, but I don't remember all of it, so it's like when I do it, it's like it's kind of hard to really fit the pieces together. I try to make my kata when I was doing it in the studio more traditional way of how the samurais would do it, you know. But the instructor, he was one that added all the fancy stuff, all the flashiness. I didn't really want to do all the flashiness, but he said all the flashiness is what wins the competitions, and that's what wins the shows. And I come to realize, you know, there was this guy, he was flinging the sword up in the air, and then he like turned around and caught it behind his back, and he started flinging around. I mean, he was that good with the sword, and I just couldn't believe on how hard and how high he threw it up in the air and still caught it. And I was like, damn, that's like off the damn movies. So, not how you train. For me, I'm not into all the fanciness, I'm not into all that showmanship. I'm just into more of like traditional striking, traditional arts. I'm not really into nothing fancy. But if you like my stuff that I teach or what I show, whatever, please hit the like, hit subscribe, like most YouTubers would say, hit that bell notification, stay tuned for this video, and I'll give you guys a quick workout with the samurai story. So. 9. Now, I will give you a little advice on holding the katana. Most people think they ought to hold it like this, with two hands together like a baseball bat. You can hold it however you want, it's comfortable. But really, technically, how they hold it is that they have one hand near the scabbard, one hand near they're the bottom of the handle, and so usually on how it's held, it needs to have enough space, like a handful of space in between each hand positions. So that's a way to how you hold a katana, is where you have one hand on bottom, one hand on top. You don't hold it like a baseball bat, like how you see in the movies. Most of the time when you see people doing it in the movies, they're holding it like a baseball bat. But to me, this is how you really hold the katana, is hand on bottom, hand on top, not holding it like a baseball bat. So, little advice on katana holding. So, Nine, ten. That'd be 11, 12, 13. Fourteen, fifteen, sixteen, seventeen, eighteen, 19. Now the angles of attack be down, straight down, and 45 degree angle to the side of the neck to the body. Same with the other side. Now do horizontal. Stab. That's the angles of attack, what you can do with the sword. The reason why I do more of angle of attacks, because that way, if you're a pot, when it has a sword, you boss, and I can go in, slice to his neck, or I can step to the side over here, slice, or I can do the same thing. Or like filming. Well, I just haven't really traditional machine. 7-foot stab. So that'd be one. Figure eight. Splice. Two. Three. Four. Eight. Nine. Eight. 30 of it, Japanese katana workouts. Click the like, hit subscribe, hit that bell notification, you'll get every one of my videos. Something off for signing off. Peace.